Hello everyone, so here in this problem we have to find the maximum and minimum values of the function f of x comma y equal to 3x plus 4y on the circle x square plus y square equal to 1 using method of Lagrange's multipliers. Now whenever we want to find the value of maxima and minima by using the Lagrange's multiplier, we always find out the stationary values by using Lagrange's multiplier, and for those stationary values we find minima and maxima. So here we'll follow two steps to find out the stationary values. So here I'll say step number one, we have to find stationary values of function. Now this function is u, which is f of x comma y, and that is 3x plus 4y. I'll say this as equation number 1 on the circle. So this is the given condition. So here I'll say with the condition, so condition we denote by phi of x comma y. So it is x square plus y square minus 1 equal to 0. So this is equation number 2. Now after equation number 2, we'll consider the Lagrange's function to find out the stationary value. So here I'll say consider Lagrange's function as f of x comma y equal to f of x comma y plus lambda phi of x comma y. So here I am considering the Lagrange's function. So the value of f of x comma y is 3x plus 4y plus lambda, value of phi of x comma y is x square plus y square minus 1. So here we got the value of function f, or f of x comma y. And now we'll find out the value of df from the Lagrange's function. So to find out the df, we'll use the formula. So therefore the df is given by the formula dou f by dou x into dx plus dou f by dou y into dy. So here I am partially differentiating f with respect to x and partially differentiating f with respect to y, plus lambda as it is, and dou phi by dou x into dx plus dou phi by dou y into dy. So by partially differentiating f with respect to x and with respect to y, we will get the values as 3 and 4 respectively. So here we'll say it is equal to 3 dx plus 4 dy plus lambda. Here by partially differentiating phi with respect to x and y respectively, here we'll get 2x and 2y. So we'll say 2x dx plus 2y dy. So by solving this, here we'll get 3 dx plus 2 lambda x dx. I can take dx common, so we'll get 3 plus 2 lambda x dx in bracket and dx outside, plus 4 plus 2 lambda y in bracket into dy as value of df. So now we got the value of df, and then we'll consider df as 0. So therefore here I'll say df equal to 0 gives us 3 plus 2 lambda x equal to 0 and 4 plus 2 lambda y equal to 0. And I'll say this as equation number 3. So now we got the third equation, and now we'll solve the equation number 1, 2 and 3 to find out the stationary values. So here I'll say step number 2. So in step number 2, we will eliminate the values of x, y, z from equation 1, 2, 3. So here I'll say we have to eliminate x, y and lambda from equation number 1, 2 and 3. So from equation number 3, we will get x as minus 3 upon 2 lambda and y as minus 4 upon 2 lambda. So we got the value of x and y from equation number 3. So here I'll say from 3. Now I'll substitute this value of x and y in equation number 2. So the equation number 2 is x square plus y square minus 1 equal to 0. So this will become, therefore, square of this, that is 9 upon 4 lambda square plus square of this 16 upon 4 lambda square minus 1 equal to 0. So we got this equation from 2. Now we'll solve this. So here we will get, after adding this, 25 upon 4 lambda square, and this minus 1 will go on the right hand side. So here I'll say, therefore 25 upon 4 lambda square is equal to 1, and therefore 25 is equal to 4 lambda square, or I'll say that the lambda square is equal to 25 upon 4. So to get the value of lambda, we'll take the square root on both sides. So therefore we will get lambda as plus or minus 5 by 2. So here we got the value of lambda. Now from the value of lambda, we'll find out the value of x and y. So I'll substitute that value of lambda here to get the value of x and y. So x is minus 3 upon 2 lambda. So here I'll say, therefore, when lambda is equal to 5 by 2, we will get x as minus 3 upon 2 lambda. So 2 into 5 by 2, by cancelling 2 to, we will get minus 3 by 5, and y as minus 4 by 2 lambda. So lambda is again 5 by 2, cancelling 2 to, we will get minus 4 by 5. Next, when lambda is equal to minus 5 by 2. So when lambda is minus 5 by 2, here we will get x as minus 3 upon 2 into lambda. So lambda is minus 5 by 2, cancelling 2 and 2, cancelling minus minus, and we will get 3 by 5, and we will get y as minus 4 by 2 into lambda. Lambda is minus 5 by 2, cancelling 2, 2 and minus n will get 4 by 5. So when lambda is 5 by 2, the stationary value is minus 3 by 5 comma minus 4 by 5, and when lambda is minus 5 by 2, the stationary value is 3 by 5 comma 4 by 5. Now for these stationary values, we will find out the minima and maxima. Now to find out the minima or maxima, we generally find out the second derivative, and from second derivative we find out the value of rt minus s square. And if the RT minus S square is greater than 0, and if the value of R is greater than 0, we say it is minima. And if RT minus S square is greater than 0 and the value of R is less than 0, then we say it is maxima. So if we want to proceed with that method, then here we have to find out the second derivative. But my friends, if you'll observe the second derivative, that is dou square f by dou x square or dou square f by dou y square, then it is 0, because here first derivative will be 3, and if you'll try to find out the second derivative, you'll get 0. And similarly here, dou f by dou y is 4 and dou square f by dou y square is 0. So here we are not gonna use that usual method to find out the minima or maxima. So what we are gonna do is, we will be substituting this value of x and y directly in the function to get the minima and maxima. So by substituting value of x and y in f, so here I'll say, therefore f of x comma y is equal to 3x plus 4y, so is equal to 3 into value of x. Here we got x as minus 3 by 5 and y as minus 4 by 5. So here we'll say minus 3 by 5 plus 4 into minus 4 by 5. So here we'll get minus 9 by 5 and minus 16 by 5, that is minus 25 upon 5, or I'll say it is minus of 5. Similarly, if I'll substitute the second value in f of x comma y, that is 3x plus 4y, then we'll get x is 3 by 5 and y is 4 by 5. So here we'll get 3 into 3 by 5 plus 4 into 4 by 5, and which is positive 25 by 5, which is 5. So here I can say that this 5 is the positive value and this minus 5 is a negative value. So this is the maximum value of the function, and minus 5 is the minimum value of the given function. So here, as asked in the question, to find out the maximum and minimum value of the function f of x comma y, we got the maximum value as 5 and the minimum value as minus 5. Thank you.